Howdy guys, Jimmy Song here. I wanted to talk in this video about the update with the bet with Roger Ver, because he put out a video over the weekend saying that he would accept the bet with a caveat, which was that he wants the winner to choose which charity the loser donates to instead of actually paying out to the loser. I just wanted to give a little bit of a background on what this was. And a lot of this is from my article, which you can click through below and take a look at all of the, you know, original sources of this stuff. He claimed in the video that I had rejected three offers. I go through exactly what those three offers were. The first was on the cruise, where he didn't make it clear what he wanted it denominated in. He wants it denominated in dollars 10 years from now instead of in Bitcoin right now, which is what I want. He also doesn't make it clear that in the second one, he sort of offered, but he sort of moved the goalposts on. I wanted a 200-to-1 ratio for an early termination clause over a 24-hour period. He wanted it to be a 500-to-1 ratio for an early termination clause within a 30-day period. That lasts for a 30-day period. I conceded one half. I didn't concede the other. Anyway, he was just being kind of cagey. And this all started a while back, back in May, when he was quoted in an article saying that the flipping is imminent and that Ethereum could overtake Bitcoin by the end of the year, and that Bitcoin Cash could overcome Bitcoin by the end of 2020 or something like that. Those, I believe, were pretty much his exact words. And I asked him if he wanted to put some money behind those words, because, you know, I know that's a pretty good bet. And he was very cagey about it. I posted the entire exchange on, in that article. But I mean, he kept walking back his words, making like these mental gymnastics kind of stuff, just trying to walk back whatever he was saying. So I found it very cagey and kind of dumb, to be honest, and kind of forgot about it until the cruise itself, where I decided to call him out on this hypocrisy. And that's where he offered me the bet, and we've been going back and forth. I would write him. He would take like 3 or 4 days. And then come back with something ridiculous. This is not unlike Joe Lubin, right? The cycle of this stuff is I almost always respond within like a few hours. They take like a week, 2 weeks, and then come up with some flimsy excuse. They're scared, right? Like it should be pretty clear by now who's the scared one, who's the one that, you know, like didn't really mean it, despite the fact that I was offered both bets. So it's kind of ridiculous that they continue to act like they're the ones that are that are wanting to bet, and that I'm the one that's scared or something like that. Nothing could be further from the truth. Anyway, wanted to point that out, Roger. I did accept the bet at the very end of that article, under the condition that it gets paid in 14 days after the bet ends, whether it's through the early termination clause or the 10 years, and that the winner, all of the money has to be transferred to the winner, and the winner will put at least 25% to a charity per the winner's discretion, which is almost exactly the same, except it's not 100%, it's 25%, and the money has to be transferred to the winner first. And I have good reasons for this, and those are in the article. We'll see what he says. My guess is that he'll come up with some excuse for not doing it. And if he does do it, it'll be like, you know, he'll want some whatever weird condition that he wants, or I don't know. It's you can never really tell. He's going to try to spin it for his advantage in some way. That's almost guaranteed. Fact of the matter is he's being very weaselly, and that's been the case the entire time. Anyway, hope that helps you. Let me know in the comments what you think. I do know there's a bunch of people saying, why are you giving this guy the time of day? I think this hurts his credibility. I think it hurts Bitcoin Cash's credibility. I think when you're a liar, you need to be called out on it. So I wanted to call out his lies about his three offers that I rejected, and how he keeps moving the goalposts and so on. So hopefully that helps you. This song is done.